Good morning. Here is the disclosure of the affiliations. I'll talk about the new aspect of the patients with chronic myeloid leukemia who now live normal lives due to targeted therapy and can even think about having children. However, this information is very scarce, and the data about management of the CML patients during pregnancy are very limited. And in order to define how this population lives, how it is controlled, and what are the outcomes of pregnancy in CML patients, we started the study within European Leukemia Net. I'm sorry, I'm trying to go to next slide, but...
Well, that's fantastic with the counter there. It's beautiful.
I can talk without slides, however, with slides it could be better.
Well, this slide has been on long enough, right?
Yeah. Next. Okay. Because maybe
it starts to count again, my God.
This comes under here, sorry.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you. We have gathered the information about 305 cases in the European Leukemia Net Registry regarding the pregnancy outcome in female patients with CML. The purpose was to describe the pregnancy conception outcomes and the management of the disease in these patients, focusing on the characteristics of patients at diagnosis and at pregnancy, focusing on management of CML during pregnancy, pregnancy outcomes and characteristics of children and their follow-up. ELN registry was designed as an observational study. We invited the ELN centers and participants from other countries to register together all retrospective and prospective cases of pregnancy in CML patients. We started since February 2014, and since that time we gathered the data of 305 cases in 234 CML female patients from 13 countries worldwide. The countries were represented not only by European countries, but also countries from Asia. We gathered also cases from Argentina and USA. Very briefly, the results of the research were as follows. Most of the pregnancies in CML patients ended in labor. Labor was the most frequent outcome, so these women gave birth to children. More than two-thirds of the pregnancies were diagnosed during during treatment, and 71% of pregnancies were at conception with the TKI treatment at conceiving. These women stopped TKIs immediately after pregnancy confirmation. And also there is a category of patients who were diagnosed with CML during pregnancy. Their proportion is rather high, 25% of patients. Major or deep molecular response, which is now the goal for CML patients, was only in 44% of pregnancy cases with a known molecular status. That means that not all the patients achieved a good and stable remissions while they were pregnant. Therefore, a variety of treatment options was used during pregnancy, including interferon or imatinib or nilotinib at late pregnancy stage. However, the rate of the birth abnormalities was very low, 107%, and we didn't observe any severe or life-threatening abnormalities in born children. Their follow-up was uneventful, and now the median time of observation for these children is nearly 5 years. So a normal childbirth is possible for CML female patients. We found no increased rate of birth abnormality, even when TKIs were stopped immediately after pregnancy was discovered, and no situation for the abnormalities with imatinib or nilotinib use at late pregnancy, although these data are still limited. The results of conception and pregnancy, the study of this population may be valuable for the development of the CML treatment schemes, considering the variety of disease status and therapy options, because we do not have the recommendations for CML patients during pregnancy so far. Thank you for your attention.
Well, thank you very much for addressing this important topic in patients that live long now with CML. Any questions from the press, please? In your abstract, you write that most of the pregnancies, that's 77%, ended in labor. So what happened to the 23% that did not end in labor?
The other outcomes were induced abortion, miscarriage, and for 2% we have now the data of the outcome. So the most frequent outcome was labor, and it means that these women wanted to keep their pregnancy, wanted to prolong it, in spite of the risks that could be present while they were on targeted therapy.
Were any blast crises observed, accelerated disease in patients being pregnant and not taking tyrosine kinase inhibitors?
There were no blast crises during pregnancy. There were five deaths between all this population of more than 200 patients after the childbirth, after some period of treatment. And in fact, four of these patients were treated inadequately, and they were not compliant to therapy. So the compliance to therapy of the young women is another problem which we had to deal with in this population.
Okay.